Welcome to this video where we will learn how to clone a graph. We have a graph and we are given a vertex that can reach all other vertices. And we are asked to create a deep copy of the graph. We have to create new vertices but by keeping the same values and the same connections. To solve this problem, we can think of creating a new node that has the same value as the input node and the same neighbors. But this solution doesn't work, because what happened when we gave neighbors of the original one to the clone is that we just gave their references, so we didn't create new nodes. The clone node is pointing to the same nodes. Which means that we didn't create a deep copy of the graph, we just copied the first node, not remaining ones. This solution didn't work, what else can we try? Let's think about the same problem but for a tree. To clone a tree, we can use depth-first search. We create a node that has the same value as the root, then we traverse children of the original node, for each one of them, we clone it, and we add the result to the children of the clone. And because children of tree node are also tree nodes, we use the same function, we will have a recursive process. This solution works well for trees, we get a deep copy of the tree with new nodes and the same values and connections. Let's try it with a graph. The input node is 1, we create a copy of it. The first neighbor is 2, we go to it. We create a new node that has the same value. The first neighbor is 5, we go to it. We create a new node that has the same value. Now this one has no neighbors, so we return the node we created. It enters in neighbors of the previous node, and we backtrack. Next neighbor is 3, we create a node with the same value. No neighbors, we backtrack. The returned node enters in neighbors, because we're inserting the node returned by the recursive call. This one has no more neighbors to visit, we return it to the previous node. Back to the initial node, the next neighbor is 3, we go to it, and we create a new node with the same value. No neighbors, we backtrack. But wait, what do you notice? We can notice that unlike in the original graph, 1 and 2 aren't pointing to the same node. Even if the two nodes have the same value, but they don't have the same reference. So the one that is in neighbors of 1 is different from the one that is in neighbors of 2. Therefore, the graph we're building is different from the original one. Our solution doesn't work. First of all, why didn't we get this problem with the tree? Cloning a tree doesn't have this problem because in a tree, nodes cannot have common neighbors like 1 and 2. So each node will be cloned only once. But in a graph, with our solution, every time we go to the node with value 3 for example, we clone it again, which results in different nodes for the same value. How to fix this? Well, we want to clone a node only once, not more. So the solution is that, once we clone the value 3 for example, we store its reference in a hash table, and every time we find the value 3, we first check if we didn't clone it before. So that instead of creating again a new node, we just take the one we created before, and by doing so, all nodes going to the value 3 will have the same node in their neighbors. And our hash table will be of type int to node, our key will be an integer, for example 3, and the value will be the node we created when cloning the value 3. With the previous example, we started from 1, we create a node that has the value 1 and put it in the hash table. Node map of 1 now represents the node we just created. Then we move to 2, we don't have 2 in our hash table, so we create a node with the value, and we store it. Then we move to 5, same thing. We went back to 2, and we went to 3. We don't have 3 in the hash table, so we create a new node and store it in node map. We went back to 2, we went back to 1, and we went to 3. But now, 3 is in our hash table. Instead of creating a new node with the value 3, which would be different from the one we created before, we directly take the one in the hash table. And after it gets inserted in neighbors of 1, 1 and 2 now point to the same node. By continuing like that during the whole process, we get a clone of the whole graph at the end, which is what we wanted to do since the beginning. In code, our recursive DFS function takes as parameters the initial node and the node map. We start by creating clone, a node that has the same value as input node. Next step, we put it in node map of node.val. We put it in the hash table where the key is the integer stored. Now for each neighbor, we first check that it's in node map, because if it's not, it means that we didn't traverse it, So we call DFS on it to traverse it, create a node for it, fill it, and put it in the node map. Now that we made sure that the clone whose value is neighbor.val is in node map, we add it to neighbors of the actual clone. We add node map of neighbor.val. After the loop, our clone is ready to be returned. We return it. And in our main solution function, if node is null, then the graph is empty, we just return null. Else, we create node map, which is empty at the beginning, and we return the result returned by the recursive function by starting from the node given as input. For the time complexity, we're just performing depth first search, and the time complexity of depth first search is of length of v plus length of e, where length of v is the number of vertices of the graph, and length of e the number of edges. For the space complexity, we also get of length of v plus length of e, because we're cloning the graph. We're cloning all the length of v vertices and all the length of e edges. We reached the end of this video. I hope that you understood how to clone a graph. Suggest me problems to solve in comments, and see you in the next one.